Hey guys, this is Yvette Nicole Brown. I play Shirley on Community. I hope you know that already. This is the behind the scenes of season 4, and these are all of our puppets. This episode was my dream. When they always ask me in interviews what my dream community episode would be, it was always like I wanted puppets.
It's kind of like an Inception concept where there's a story within a story within a story. And the final story was kind of an animated world. What kind of animation do you want? Just so you know, it'd be cheaper to do puppets. And that's when the writer's room was like, puppets, interesting. And there was this kind of collective excitement / fear. And it was kind of that fear that was like the nugget that was like, oh, this could be something really fun to do.
Whew, puppets, okay, we're going to have to, you know, they all have to stand and work with their hands up here, so everything has to be raised. So the first thing we thought was, we can't do this in the middle of our production run. This has to be the last thing that we do.
And are we putting the doll in, or is that a separate part?
Did you just call him the doll?
I'm sorry.
Doll?
He's one of our actors, man.
The other talent? The two shot? Yeah.
No puppets.
These are not mere puppets, Jeffrey. I'm about to guide you through some non-directive cognitive behavioral therapy.
Don't try to dress it up with a fancy $5 word because, oh, I found it. It's a thing.
Think of them as little felt vessels for your feelings to help express to me what happened. Don't worry. You're in good hands. I've done this for others before.
Chang pops in the doorway with a makeshift Kevin puppet.
Puppet Kevin here thinks I should have a candy bar right now.
No, Gollum, no! You know how it winds you up. Fine, we'll split it.
I think our show has always been the closest live-action show to a cartoon that's possible. So for me, I'm always very happy anytime we get to go animated and do things that maybe we couldn't really do in the world of Greendale.
There's the versions of the puppets that I made, that Dean made. And then there's the puppets that are for the adventure, which are much more intricate and much more advanced and awesome.
Oh, brace for impact!
I should mention that the puppets were built by Scott Johnson and Russ Walco and Jürgen Ferguson and Sarah Skinner.
Scott and Drew, who are the puppet maestros on this episode, are so knowledgeable, and this is what they do every day. You know, they've been along the process all the whole way. You know, it's been great.
So Scott got photos of the actors, did caricature drawings of them in 2D, and then he did some mock-ups in a program called ZBrush just to get an idea of shape and color, and then started building and mocking up the puppets and getting general head shape. And a lot of times these are actually built with flat foam that's curved and formed into a three-dimensional shape, and then that form is broken apart, patterned, put back together, and then they put the finishing touches, which includes the fabric covering, which is a whole art unto itself, which is then glued down at the corners of the mouth very carefully.
My puppet looks like me, eerily, except I don't have a huge line where my entire, like half my head moves up and down. Thank God, or I don't think I could book many jobs.
I love Joel's puppet because of the eyebrow. The eyebrow goes like 6 feet in the air. It's so funny.
And look, they have watches and rings and jewelry, and Shirley even has a little cleavage. I always have just a little bit of cleavage. I can't control it, and apparently my puppet can't either.
I have one, and I had it yesterday, and I was trying to figure out what it was. One, it's the worst skin color. I mean, not that I have glowing skin, but I don't know what the color is, but it's pale. And it looks like, to me, if you put ears on it, it's a human form of the creature that sat at the bottom of Jabba the Hutt in that movie, that horrible puppet that just sort of laughed. So that's what I realized what I look like.
Every time we get to see a puppet version of ourselves, I am always a little bit surprised because I'm like, oh yeah, I got a big face. So I have to get over that because that's just my thing. I have to get over that. I know I have a big face, okay? So once I get over that, I move on, and then I rejoice, and I take pictures, and I send them to my wife, and my friends, and my mom, and I say, look at this puppet version of me. It's totally not me, right? And they respond, they're like, spot on. That is exactly you. And then we all rejoice. I laugh. I get over it, we laugh, and then I realize that I'm a joke.
This is real hair, like the hair department for Community styled their hair, so you'll see Anthony or Loretta or Jade from our hair department coming and tweaking the look of all of the puppets' hair.
The hair looks great. They got some amazing wigs for Annie and Britta and Shirley. You not so much, sorry buddy. I mean, it looks great, it looks perfect, but it's not as impressive. Cool, whatever.
On a lot of them, I'm surprised on how much emotion you can get from just the eyeballs and the eyebrows shifting. The amount of emotion that these puppets can evoke is just, so it's actually really joyful, it's really cool.
I talked to one of the puppeteers today and she was saying what she loves to do is find a way to make the character react without opening her mouth. So she's learning how to make an eyebrow raise resonate just as much as her going, hey, now.
Working with the puppets is great fun. The only disorienting part, really, is you're working on sets that are elevated, and everything you're working with, really, is below your eye line, and you've got to keep your eyes in the world. So you have to really immerse yourself in the make-believe. You have to really deal with the puppets.
The point is, out here, you have everything you need, and you can be whoever you want to be.
The process of actually puppeteering on set is, I mean, it's basically like any other acting gig for us, except that one of the main differences is the puppeteers have monitors and they always get a camera feed. Your puppet character, basically, since it doesn't have eyes, I mean, we need that so we can make our puppets look good if they're supposed to look at something in the frame.
When you see the puppets around the study room table, they're under the table on their backs with a monitor. So imagine your hand up watching a monitor and everything you do here, it's a mirror reflection on the monitor. Say you're doing the Shirley puppet and she has to shake Annie's hand who's to my right. You're watching it and it's your left.
It's funny, once you get used to it, it's just with you. And you know, actually, like if you have some, like a piece of food on your face and it's on that side of your face, I will flip around and point here and you'll do it like a mirror and I'm like, no, other side.
There's so much mental stuff going on aside from them doing the voices and working the eyebrows and moving the mouth and whatever. They also have to remember to stay spatially in the frame, and it's just a thousand different things.
I did go to production meetings and help determine like how high the sets should be built, because with every puppet production, most sets need to be built higher so that the puppeteers can basically stand up while they're working. That's the best way to do it. In the Community study room, we actually gutted the chairs, took out the seats so that we could fit up sort of through them. So we basically just had the frame with the chair backs. And it's a glorious cheat for us because it allows us maximum comfort.
You were on a runaway balloon, you could have died! How could you let him almost die?
Dean, we almost died, but we all didn't.
Although I got pretty hairy after that, especially once Pierce started helping.
Puppet world flashback, the puppet friends drift away in the hot air balloon.
Okay, everyone, push down with me at the same time. One, two, three. Come on, everyone, I can't do this alone.
You can't do this at all.
Oh, look, a downstring.
Pierce, no!
The success of it all hinges on the actor dubbing it over successfully. It works this way, and then we can get it, lay down all the visuals, and then come back and they dub it over, and usually it works great.
It feels like the live people have just molded into these puppets, and you know, the puppeteers are so amazing at getting all the gesticulation and the characters they're playing into the puppets.
I think they take it very seriously about recreating that stuff, and I think that's pretty cool that they're that specific.
I watched a lot of episodes, just try to figure out you know, the general sort of bird-like head movements and demeanor and cadence, and that's the most important thing.
There was something about the notion of it working with the puppets that I thought, well, wouldn't it be fun if I had a little bit of a puppet feel myself? If you notice, my hands are kind of open and flat, like the puppets. The puppets can't articulate their fingers, so I thought, wouldn't it be fun if I can't articulate my fingers too?
You ready?
Hey, Shirley.
Hey.
Yep, time to go for a balloon ride.
I'm so excited.
I'm not.
Why not?
Gravity is our enemy. I don't know if people know how dangerous it is.
What are you talking about?
Yep, gravity can kill you.
Gravity was invented by God.
No. Yep. So were typhoons and Ebola.
Oh, that's wrong.
I agree. So you're saying basically God is wrong. All right, let's go.
No, I didn't. Wait, you are. Oh, I'm. Mm-mm.
The messing around we do in between shots and in between the actual scenes is some of the funniest stuff because it's totally unexpected. And also why we do that, we do a lot of messing around in between, is to really get a feel for our puppets.
What's wrong? You're a friend.
Get back, back off. Back away. Back away. Back. Stay, stay.
It's called an early bird.
Line. In the sand.
You obviously don't like.
Oh, yeah.
It really is sort of an out-of-body experience, and the more you mess with it, the more it becomes second nature. And the better your eye focus gets, the more comfortable you get with your surroundings.
The puppeteers really worked hard to mimic us and our movements. So when you meet them, they're like, hey, like they move like you, and it's really freaky. Like the Abed puppeteer moved just like Abed. And I'm like, that's so weird that he knows, like he like his blinks and like everything was, I was like, how did they do that? They got really into it, and it was awesome.
What? I don't know. Just looking at you, deep in your soul.
It's a really fun episode. It's got a lot of songs, a lot of collaboration.
I come from the theater, and the thing that really rang my bell and made me want to be an actor was musicals.
Sarah and Adam and my friend Alex, we're actually all of us are really old friends, and when I got this opportunity, I just casually approached them, and they were like, yeah, they were really excited.
I'm a musician, and I write a lot of music, but I don't get to do it for these kinds of specific things, so it was really fun. It was really fun for me to do.
You might recognize this lady.
I love her. I kind of assaulted you in the makeup trailer this morning.
Yeah, I know.
She was going for the handshake, and I made her hug me. And then I quizzed her on what her favorite singer, who her favorite singer-songwriters were, who your favorite singers were. And then I told her all my favorite songs that she's created. So I'm not proud of myself. I don't think I made you feel welcome. I made you feel stalked,
yeah,
but
no,
I love you.
No, it's good. I mean, I'm security.
Yes, yeah, over. Okay, all right, yeah, thank you.
Seeing that puppet just made me laugh, and you know, I showed it to my wife and kids, and I grew up on that, you know, so to be made into puppet form, again, it's like being made into Christmas ornament form, to be memed, you know, online. That's what the show is all about, and I can't think of a better way to go out than shooting a puppet episode.
Oh, that's the best thing ever.
We are just a regular TV show, and to try and make it feel, give it a cinematic quality and make it feel interesting and different and not just like the puppets are in the foreground, you know, just to try and give it some depth and some scale and some bring some storytelling to it is, I guess, my challenge.
Even in storytelling, you can be a lot simpler when you enter the puppet world.
And that's, again, another way that I think our show is something that I am so proud of in so many ways, because we're able to go to different places, like have puppets designed for us that people work really hard on and make beautiful.
It's kind of fun. I feel like this show has let us live all these like
yeah
dreams that you didn't know you had, like again to call come back to narcissism, but you know what I mean, you're just
yeah.
Oh, puppet version of myself, that's awesome. It kind of is great.
I know, I have like a Brita Bot figurine at home. Whoever thought, you know, we would be on a show that you get to have all of these things.
Yeah, to see yourself in claymation and then as a puppet.
So that's what we are. We're wrapping up. We're, you know, as I speak, this is our last week of this production on season 4.
I think that's, it's really hard at the end. Like Gillian's, you know, Gillian's probably gonna cry, and she always does.
I'll probably cry. I cried last year when we did that interview on the like the last
that's
day of
true.
Shooting.
And I always thought I was the sappiest one in the group. I'm not. A lot of people cry way more than me at the end of a season.
Gillian will be the first to cry.
I'm usually just emotionally exhausted by that point because, like, you know, you work really hard.
Although we probably won't like to admit it, we'll even miss the long hours, you know, because we have become a family, and it's going to be tough, man.
For me, it's always been my dream to work with people and be surrounded by people who love what they're doing and who are making me laugh, and I get to learn from them. And that's another one of those episodes where I look and I'm like, wow, there's all kinds of stuff that's new to me that I've never been able to do. So it's pretty cool that we're still doing new things in our very last episode in season 4.
Would you like to see my Oprah?
You get a car! You and you and you get a car!
I've been working on it. This is the best thing I've ever seen.